I saw this article on ultimateguitar.com. Top 25 easiest guitar riffs of all time. I figured we should put that to the test, see if they are truly easy. Now, I have done videos in the past where I learn the hardest guitar solo of a given band or guitar player, and I always have a lot of fun and get really good feedback with those videos. So I figured this would be a different kind of test for the ear training that I like to employ in those videos, where I'm only going to listen to these songs one time. And some of them I'm sure I've already heard. I actually haven't even looked at this list. I saw the first one, which is by the Scorpions, Rock Me Like a Hurricane. I've heard that. So if I've heard the riff before, then whatever. I probably haven't listened to these in a while. I don't know what this list is all about. But the point is, I am going to listen to whatever the song is one time and see if I can pick it up by ear. And then we will truly know if these are the 25 easiest guitar riffs of all time. By the way, I also want to let you know, if you want to sign up for guitar lessons with me, I have an awesome platform called Guitar Super System, and thousands of you have already signed up since I released it in late fall 2018, which I'm very grateful for. I've been getting some great feedback from you guys, so make sure to check down below in the description for a link to sign up today. Now let's get started with number 25, Scorpions, Rock You Like a Hurricane. I assume they mean like the very beginning or the main riff. I assume they're not meaning like the blistering solo. Let's hear it. Oh, video unavailable. Starting off with a bang, let's go to iTunes. All right, I assume that's what they're talking about since we're going with easy. So that sounds like... So it's probably a half step down because this is an E flat. Yep. Oh. I even learned more of the song even though I didn't listen to it. I've definitely heard that one a million times before, so far so good. This list is very accurate. Okay, David Bowie, The Man Who Sold the World is number 24. I cannot hum this song to save the life of me. I've probably heard it, but...
This is a song I'm very proud to have written. It's been covered no end of times, and
David Bowie flexing on everyone. I've written this song, I'm very proud of it. Everybody's covered it. Yeah. Okay. That's easy. So what's the root note? So if you want to make it a little bit cooler on its own, you can tune to drop D and have the root note ringing. So it's a root note and then an F. And you can play that kind of like a double stop. All right, pretty easy. Black Sabbath, Paranoid is number 23. I actually included this in 50 amazing licks on 50 different amazing guitars, a video that I made. People were saying, since I picked these notes, no, I didn't play it wrong. I didn't play it with the right articulations though, according to the very wise and amazing guitar players of YouTube comments. So let's make sure I get it right here. So I shouldn't be picking these notes. I should be hammering them. So, all in all. Okay, pretty easy. Number 22, Tenacious D, One Note Song. I should be able to handle this one, right?
Jack.
Yeah?
Do you think there's some people that are actually robots?
Can I just say Tenacious D is the greatest band in the world?
Among Us?
No.
That we can't tell?
No, we don't have the technology yet. But Raid.
All right, let's find the one note.
Just do what I do.
Okay.
Just play this note. And then we both keep keep playing that note. That's one song in the bank.
Okay. And it's a D. Get it? Tenacious D. Hold on, let me get a little bit more. Well, let me put some clean on at least. That might be the easiest one yet. Okay, let's move on. Number 21, Blur, song 2. Can't say I remember this one. Oh yeah, I do. That drum beat. Jin 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 jin. So I wonder which part of it they're referring to. We'll do the heavy part. Sounds like it's stacked fifth chords. So far, this list is extremely accurate. 20, Nirvana, Something in the Way. That's not the one I would have picked, but then again, I can't really recall this song. First of all, why would you ever want to play this song? Sounds like it's just an F. I can't replay it. it sounded like crap. I don't know if it's the YouTube rip of the song or if that's actually how it sounds, but it sounded like a really heavy bass. It's F to C sharp. I don't know what chords he's playing. I guess it's just like a... I guess I have to pretend I'm like... half drunk. It almost sounds like I remember hearing the high note. So maybe he's doing octaves. Nobody should ever learn this song. Number 19, Alice in Chains, Angry Chair.
Quit being so angry, Chair.
I may have an angry chair too. I don't think I've ever heard this song, but I've said that already a couple times. All right. Okay, it's an E flat. So I guess, I mean, this list didn't say these are the best guitar riffs ever, they're the easiest. Number 18, Stone Temple Pilots, Vaseline. Oh, I know this song. Whine-a, 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 whine-a. Now this is a song you should learn. It's really Sabbath-y.
Is it me? Is it you?
Oh, another Black Sabbath, number 17, Black Sabbath, Iron Man. I don't even have to play this one. Actually, I do. Let me make sure I get the key right. Yeah, I almost started on C, it's in B. Moving on. Pantera, Walk. Ah, another one that I was scrutinized for in the lick video that I did. I'll dial in a heavier sound. All right, let's make sure I get this right. Yeah, it's really all about the, you know, the sauce that you put on that bend and the scooped midness. I'm not going for tone here. I'm just going to try and play the riff. And by the way, yeah. There we go. Let's move on. The Kinks, You Really Got Me, comes in at number 15. Let's see what key this is in. I already know the riff. Oh. Listen to that just stanky guitar sound. Okay, I think that's what it is. This one's actually hard because I feel like it could have been that or it could have been. I should have listened to it longer. I think that's what it could have been. It's the Kinks, so it was recorded. It could have been recorded like out of tune a little bit. Actually, it definitely was out of tune. I think it's F to G.
Girl, you really got me now.
The Rolling Stones, I Can't Get No Satisfaction. Let's see here. Very easy. Moving forward, Limp Bizkit, Break Stuff. I don't think I've ever tried to play a Limp Bizkit song on guitar. Let's find out what happens. It's just one of those days when you don't wanna wake up. Okay. Boom, man. Probably a drop tuning. Yep, it's an E flat. So it's a tritone. I don't feel like tuning the E flat. We're just gonna go. I don't know if he's doing a power chord on the tritone. I think it more matters about the attitude. All right, moving on. Number 12, Ramones, I Wanna Be Sedated. Why would you wanna be that, Johnny Ramone? All right, that keeps going. Bam, bam, bam. Again, I'm just taking the first parts of these riffs because I assume that's what this article is talking about. This actually sounds not so easy off the surface. It sounds like it could be more than just a power chord, but I could be wrong. Let's see. No, it's a power chord. The good thing about punk power chords is you just flick off your audience, so that's really punk. Consider yourself sedated, Mr. Ramone. Let's move on. Alice in Chains, Man in the Box. All right, I know the wow, wow, wow. All right, I think this is in drop D. No, E flat. We'll stay in E. And then let's see if we can figure this part out just for giggles. Definitely learned that one. Number 10, Black Sabbath, Black Sabbath. Lots of Sabbath on here. Just wanted to get the root note. F sharp, the heaviest of keys. Alright, so obviously it helps if you know these songs like by heart, you've heard them enough to pick them up as fast as I am, but still, these are really easy. Green Day, Brain Stew Jaded is number 9. Don't think I've ever heard this song. Oh, yeah, I have. I just didn't know the title. Alright. Alright, that's it. Damn it, it's in a freaking drop key again. So we'll push it up again. Oh yeah. Good old Green Day, always good for an easy riff. Megadeth, Symphony of Destruction. Huh. Apparently this is the 8th easiest guitar riff of all time. How do you feel about that, Dave Mustaine? Okay. Let's grab a little more dirt. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, that is pretty easy. I might put that a little lower on the list though, because it has the palm muting and that's kind of quick. Napalm Death, You Suffer is number 7. Pretty sure I've never heard this song. Ah, it's too sad. Oh my god. I can't listen to that again. Oh. I think I might need tabs for this one. Is it just like that? Or is it like, no, I don't think I heard a chord. I wasn't even ready. I didn't look at the time or anything. Oh, All right, I'm giving myself a pass on this one. I get to listen to it again. I had no idea that was 2 seconds. Let's see if I can get the note. Okay, I think I hear a drop tuning. Because I think it ended on E flat. No. I think that's as close as I'm gonna get. That was hilarious. Oh, another Ramones! Blitzkrieg Bop! Number 6. Seems simple enough. Of the fourth. Hey! Oh! Let's go to number 5. Come As You Are, Nirvana. I don't need to listen to this one. Let's put on some clean. I think Kirk played that last chord though. Number 4, Judas Priest, Breaking the Law. That's number 4. Are they going like by the easiest is at the top of the list or the bottom? Because that had a couple tricky ones. Listening to it one time makes it harder. So I heard the A. That's kind of a tongue twister. I wouldn't call that the easiest in the world. Let me get some gain. This one's probably going to take me the longest. I guess that's the easiest way to play it. I don't know if he's in a drop tuning. No, he's not in a drop tuning. Because this is kind of a hard stretch. That's what it was. Hopefully I'm right. I wouldn't put that at number 4 though, Ultimate Guitar. I think you guys are wrong on that one. Number 3, White Stripes, Seven Nation Army, duh. Except this isn't this like a bass line? I mean, I know he plays guitar on it too, but I can't even do this on guitar. I need an octave effect, so I'll just. I mean, that's what it is. Let's see if I can make it more interesting for you guys. Can't make that one interesting. 2, Deep Purple, Smoke on the Water. Oh, Smoke on the Water, wow. What an original pick. For 2, easiest guitar riff ever. All right, make sure you play it in the right key. That's not it. That's not it. That's it. Do you play it like that? Or up here? Kind of sounds meter up here. And the 1 easiest guitar riff of all time. Metallica, Nothing Else Matters. What? Okay. You can't just play the first 4 strings of this riff that's not playing the song. They're obviously saying... That's not the riff. Like, you're not playing Nothing Else Matters just by playing those notes. Wow, you guys got it way wrong. That's awful, I can't believe that's 1. In case you're wondering, this is how Nothing Else Matters goes after the part that you say is the easiest guitar riff of all time. Yeah, definitely the easiest guitar riff of all time. Okay, aside from that terrible 1 pick by the Ultimate Guitar community, you guys nailed it. I'd say pretty much all those are the easiest guitar riffs ever written. Obviously, you can mix and match a few here or there, but it was a fun little challenge. I would definitely recommend any beginner guitar players try these riffs out. They are excellent selections, except for that one Nirvana one. I actually think the Napalm Death song was better than that as far as a guitar riff goes. But who am I to judge? I'm just some idiot inside your computer or cell phone. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks a lot for watching. And until next time, keep shredding.